Good morning, family and friends. This is your girl, Charlene, back with another encouraging, inspiring video. Want to help you to live your best life with God. He gave you another day. I'm back up at it. So you get up, get back at it, see what God has in store for you. We made it through all the trials and tribulations of yesterday, and He has a wonderful, blessed day in store for you and me. So get up, get moving. Don't lay there listening to the devil giving you all type of excuses not to handle your business. This is the day that the Lord has made, so we will rejoice and be glad in it. Today, I want to bring you a quick message, as usual. Today's title of a message is, Don't Give Up on Your Dreams. Did you hear what I said? You who watching this, don't give up on your dreams. I don't care how old you are. I don't care how many times you failed. I don't care what has tried to stop you. Get back up. Keep fighting. Keep trying. Never give up. If God gave you another day, it's another opportunity to keep trying. I know life can be hard. I know it can be rough some days, but God built you tough. Tough enough to withstand anything, no matter what storm, what trial, what tribulations you got going on. God has made you strong enough to withstand you. I know life ain't fair. I know sometimes life is hard. Life is rough. But if you trust in the Lord, if you put your faith in Him, if you just wait on the Lord, things will work out. God is faithful to do His part, but we got to get up and do our part. God is always going to do what He says, because He is a God that does not lie. But you got to get up and do your part, because God won't do everything, but He will do His part. So you get up. You get to doing your part. Whatever that dream is that God put in you, you've got to walk it out. You've got to pray it out. You've got to be determined to see it come to pass. God put that dream into you. A lot of people may not understand it, but that's because it's not their dream. It's the dream that God put in you. Let me tell you something. People don't understand my dream moving to California. I heard every excuse. Well, I shouldn't say I heard every excuse. I heard plenty of reasons of people saying I was crazy, it's expensive, it's earthquakes, it's on fire. You know what? And all of that's true. But regardless of that, I had a dream in my heart. I had something that God put in me, and I wasn't gonna stop until I got there. I was tired of being in cold weather, in misery. I know some of y'all that's watching this can relate, cause y'all still there. When I had got out of high school, I said I was gonna move someplace that was warm all year round. And instead of moving someplace warm, I ended up in Detroit, Michigan for over 20 years. And that was as cold as Toledo. So I finally got determined that if I had breath in my body, I was gonna make it to some place that was warm. I was gonna go someplace that had sunshine and blue skies most of the time. And what better place than California? People was like, why you wanna go to California? I'm like, because I can. God didn't tell me I couldn't, so I'ma do it. I was blessed with a career. I could point my finger wherever I wanna go and have a job. I don't know if y'all know, I'm a physical therapist assistant. I work with kids, and a physical therapist assistant is needed everywhere. I started to go to Hawaii, but I said, that's a little bit too far. So my second choice was California. Let me tell y'all something. It's been rough. It's been hard. but it's worth it. Every day, or most days, is blue skies, is sunshine. That makes a difference on how you feel. If you just wake up and the sun is shining, do you know how good that feels? It is April, I don't know, the beginning of April. I don't even know the date, but it's Wednesday, I do know that. And I'm out here, look, short sleeve, you see me? Short sleeves. That's what I'm talking about. This past weekend, Jordan and them was out there swimming. That's what I like. That was part of my dream. And until I got it, I couldn't stop. I have to say, the way I did it was not the best way. But glory be to God. He has kept me. He has covered me every step of the way. I can't take the credit for it. And when your dreams come to pass, you can't take the credit for it. You have to give the credit to God, because without Him, you couldn't do it. Matter of fact, Matthew 19:26 says, but Jesus looked at them and said, with man this is impossible, but with God, all things are possible. Did you hear that? With God, all things are possible. All good things, not no evil, wicked things, but all things are possible with God. So if you got God on your side, you can't fail. You will make it. But let me tell you something. It ain't gonna go like you planned. It ain't gonna go according to how you want. But if you keep fighting, if you keep digging in, if you keep praying, if you keep trying, if you keep getting up, if you keep thanking the Lord, if you keep praising the Lord, if you keep loving on people, if you keep doing your best and praying about the rest, your dreams will come to pass. I'm a living witness. My dreams are coming to pass. Now, there's still a bunch of more dreams that I have inside of me, but I can check one of my dreams off my bucket list. I'm living it. I'm in California. Blue skies and sunshine. Do you see it? Do you see it? Do you see it behind me? Just beautiful. I'm surrounded by mountains, by beautiful scenery, something that I never seen growing up in Toledo or when I moved to Michigan. This is beautiful. Some of y'all might be okay where you at, but I wasn't. I wasn't happy. I wasn't fulfilling my purpose. I wasn't living my dream. And I just got tired of playing. I got tired of making excuses. I got tired of being miserable. So I said, you know what? I'ma let stuff go, because stuff was holding me down. I gave a lot of stuff away, packed stuff up, what I could keep or what I wanted to keep, and I let it go. I let stuff go, I let the past go, I let fears go, and I just stepped out on faith. But like I said, y'all, it was some rough points. It was some points that I wasn't happy at, but I continued to go, and I continued to fight, and I continued to get up. And I continue to make it, and I continue to feel better. I continue to get where I want to be. I'm not where exactly I want to be, but I'm grateful where I'm at. I'm better than I was yesterday. I got a new day. So you got to put your mind and you got to get focused on the dream that God put in front of you. And let me tell you something. It's gonna be some haters. It's gonna be some haters with some haterade out there. But in spite of what they say, you better remember what God say. Everybody ain't gonna be happy for you. People gonna be mad. They gonna talk about you. I know they be talking about me. I don't care. Because guess what? I'm living my life, the best life God gave me. I know y'all be talking about me, and that's okay. Because guess what? God hear what you're saying. And every word that you say will be written down. So you will have to Stand account for the words that you say against me or anybody else. But I don't let the haters stop me. What I do is help let the haters elevate me. I love when somebody say I can't do nothing. Tell me I can't do something and watch how hard I try. And that's how you have to be. You can't listen to the naysayers. You can't listen to the haters. They give you all type of reasons not to follow your dreams.